There are a few crucial things you must understand about cardio. If done incorrectly, cardio could leave you softer, weaker, and even skinny fat. Done correctly, on the other hand, and cardio could accelerate your fat loss, leaving you absolutely ripped without forcing you to sacrifice your hard-earned muscle. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to perform cardio effectively and have the perfect cardio routine for non-stop fat loss. Now, before I give you the cardio blueprint, let's first talk about why you would do cardio in the first place. While there are obvious health benefits, this video is focused on how it affects your physique. There are two major ways to burn fat. One is a large stimulus to your muscles, and two is a calorie deficit. The first one may sound a bit strange, but all I'm referring to is the novel effect that resistance training has on your body. When you first got to the gym, the stimulus of lifting weight was so significant that your body adapted by building muscle relatively quickly. In order to provide the fuel needed to synthesize the new muscle tissue, your body likely burns some fat. Unfortunately, muscle building and fat loss involve opposing cellular processes. Basically, after the first few months, most people's bodies will adapt and won't really experience much of any fat loss from simply lifting weights. The second and most important way to burn fat is by eating in a calorie deficit. In other words, consuming fewer calories than you burn. For example, if your body currently burns 2,500 calories per day on average and you only eat 2,000 calories per day, your body will burn about 500 calories of fat to supply the required energy for your body's functions. That's fat loss in a nutshell. So do we even need cardio for fat loss? The simple answer is no. But because cardio burns calories, it's a great tool that most people will find helpful when trying to achieve their fat loss goals. Remember, cardio simply makes it easier to achieve a calorie deficit. So then the question becomes, how much cardio should you actually be doing each day? You could say that if cardio helps you achieve a calorie deficit to burn fat, why not just do more? But first, cardio doesn't burn as much fat as you think. Research by Quinn and colleagues suggests more cardio isn't necessarily better. In fact, if all you did was look at research, you'd think that cardio doesn't do much of anything. This can be partially explained by the fact that cardio doesn't burn nearly as many calories as you think. If it says you burn 500 calories on a piece of cardio equipment, it doesn't mean that's truly how many calories you burned, as these recordings are quite inaccurate. According to Harvard Health Publishing, for a 155-pound person, 30 minutes of general activity on the stair-step machine will only burn 223 calories. While it sounds okay, this could be undone with just two bananas. Second, doing more cardio won't help as much as you think because our bodies adapt to our exercise. According to a 2012 study, people don't burn as much fat as their calculations suggest when they do cardio. The reasons are twofold. First, some people simply eat more when they do cardio, whether they realize it or not. And second, your body experiences metabolic adaptations. In order to resist what your body senses as starvation, your metabolism gradually decreases as you diet and exercise. Of course, this doesn't mean your exercise is pointless. It's just not as effective at burning fat as it was. That's why proper nutrition is so important. And third, doing more cardio causes a cardio interference effect. Allow me to illustrate with this research. Participants were divided into a strength group that included lifting weights, an endurance group doing cardio, and a strength and endurance group that did both. The strength group gained significantly more strength than the other groups. The results suggest that doing cardio limits your resistance training workouts. Further research confirms that you simply won't gain as much muscle if you do too much cardio. But while cardio won't help much if done by itself, combining our perfect cardio routine with a proper nutrition plan can be a powerful strategy. So before moving forward, just remember that nutrition is number one for fat loss, and the right cardio plan will accelerate these results even more. With all this in mind, a great recommendation is to do only as much cardio as needed. For most, 0 to 2 sessions of cardio per week is a great starting point. Then you can add additional cardio sessions, additional minutes of cardio, or change the type of cardio as needed over the course of a fat loss phase. Which type of cardio is best? There are a few different types of cardio. Low-intensity steady-state cardio, or LISS, medium-intensity steady-state cardio, or MISS, high-intensity interval training, or HIIT. LISS is essentially just moving at a steady pace. The most common example is walking on a treadmill or outside. This is great because it's low impact and can burn some extra calories. On the downside, it just doesn't burn as many calories in total. Medium intensity steady state cardio is the classic jog that people do when they think of cardio. Unfortunately, this type of cardio is most linked to interfering with muscle and strength, possibly due to elevating cortisol or increased muscle damage that impacts recovery. High intensity interval training is the most time efficient as you'll be burning more calories in shorter periods of time. This makes sense considering how HIIT works. Rather than being steady state, it works by alternating between max effort intervals and low effort intervals. For example, let's say you do 6 rounds of HIIT on a recumbent bike. Each round could be 20 seconds of going as hard as you physically can, immediately followed by 60 seconds of active recovery to bring down your heart rate. Personally, I prefer a 1-3 max to low effort ratio. Another great aspect of HIIT is that it burns additional calories after the workout itself. This is called excess post-exercise oxygen consumption, or EPOC, also known as the afterburn effect. And no, HIIT does not burn hundreds of calories by boosting your metabolism outside of the workout. However, it does help by burning something like 25 to 50 additional calories in the 24 hours post-workout. Surprisingly enough, HIIT doesn't seem to hinder muscle and strength if you limit the amount, likely because it more closely mimics resistance training than, say, jogging. HIIT has even been shown to help you build muscle. Unfortunately, this is only realistic for certain populations, such as those who are very sedentary or overweight. With all that being said, your perfect cardio routine is going to focus on low-intensity steady-state cardio and high-intensity interval training, since LISS provides additional calorie burning without impacting workouts much, and HIIT is efficient in burning a lot of calories and spares muscle mass. So when do we do cardio? This one is pretty simple. If you do cardio immediately before lifting, you'll be directly impacting your muscle and strength gains. Doing a cardio workout before lifting will greatly fatigue you and deplete the fuel in your body. It would make more sense to do cardio immediately after resistance training. However, if you have the time, you can separate your cardio and weightlifting sessions altogether. Just make sure to allow at least 6 hours and a meal or two in between to replenish your body. The perfect cardio routine. Finally, what will your perfect cardio routine look like? My favorite form of exercise equipment is the recumbent bike, as studies suggest that cycling has minimal negative impact on muscle and strength, likely because it mimics the movement patterns you do with resistance training. For LISS, limit each session to 20 to 60 minutes maximum. I recommend starting on the lower end and gradually adding more from there. LISS cardio can be performed more often than HIIT cardio without much negative impact on lifting, if any at all. For HIIT, I recommend 5 to 10 minute rounds, 2 to 3 times per week max. If you're doing true HIIT, it'll be tough or even detrimental to do more than that. At the beginning of your fat loss phase, your cardio routine could look something like this. Monday, 6 rounds of HIIT. Thursday, 30 minutes of low intensity steady state cardio. In the middle of your fat loss phase, this could change to something like this. Monday, 8 rounds of HIIT. Thursday, 45 minutes of low intensity steady state cardio, and Saturday, another 6 rounds of HIIT. Toward the end of your fat loss phase, it would look something like this. Monday, 8 rounds of HIIT. Thursday, 60 minutes of low intensity steady state cardio, and Saturday, 8 more rounds of HIIT. Or Monday, 8 rounds of HIIT. Thursday, 45 minutes of low intensity steady state cardio, Saturday, 6 rounds of HIIT, and Sunday, another 30 minutes of low intensity steady state cardio. Remember, cardio should only be added as needed. When weight loss has stalled, you have two choices: increase cardio or decrease calorie intake. I highly recommend that you never do both. And if you're experiencing more fatigue well into your fat loss phase, consider replacing one or all HIIT sessions with more low intensity steady state cardio. So there you have it, the perfect cardio routine for nonstop fat loss. Just remember, nutrition is number one. Following the guidelines in this video, however, will accelerate those fat loss results. Did you find this video helpful? If so, click the like button below, as it'll truly help out the channel. Also, if you're an intermediate or advanced lifter who's looking to get absolutely shredded without cutting out your favorite foods or doing hours of cardio each week, grab a copy of my brand new program, Shredded 12 Fat Loss. This is the only science-based fat loss program of its kind that protects your hard-earned muscle mass and strength and gives you a shredded physique in just 12 weeks. And right now, you can get an additional 25% off by using the coupon code RIP25. If you want to learn more, click the link in the description below. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe for more videos and don't forget to turn on post notifications so you don't miss the next one. Peace.